Hello friend, I Naushad Alam, LLM from Delhi University, a practicing advocate currently associated with Delhi High Court Legal Service Committee, today present a module titled Alternate Dispute Resolution, the Rationale for ADR. First, I will be describing you what is alternate dispute resolution. Secondly, I will be describing you adjudication of dispute by the court of law, its shortcomings and the reason behind the shortcomings. Thirdly, I will be describing ancient form of ADR or dispute resolution mechanism. Fourthly, I will be describing you present form of ADR and statute governing them. Next, I will be describing you benefit of alternative dispute resolution mechanism. Next, I will be describing you one of the form of alternative dispute resolution mechanism, that is arbitration, duty of the arbitrator and approach of adjudication. Next, I will be describing you mediation and conciliation technique and approach. Next, I will be describing you judicial settlement. This is settlement under Code of Civil Procedure through Lok Adalat or with the intervention of the court. After that, I will be giving you brief outline of Lok Adalat's technique and approach. Next, I will be giving you matrimonial dispute and approach of family court when disputes are brought before it. After that, I will be taking you briefly to industrial dispute and the mechanism of settling the industrial dispute. At the end, I will be taking you plea bargaining, a new approach in criminal justice system to settle a criminal dispute or to settle a criminal trial. And lastly, I will be describing you how this ADR mechanism is an endeavor to approach constitutional goal of India and how it benefits the society in present modern days. As I told you that firstly I will be telling you what is alternate dispute resolution mechanism. Friends, there are two ways to resolve the dispute which may arise in day to day life of the modern society, either to approach court of law or to resort to alternative dispute resolution mechanism, which consists of variety of approaches to early intervention and dispute resolution or peaceful practices for resolving conflict. Alternative dispute resolution mechanism includes arbitration, conciliation, mediation, settlement with the intervention of Lok Adalat, Panchayat, etc. Adjudication of dispute by the court of law. There are various shortcomings of adjudication of dispute by court of law. These shortcomings in briefly can be summarized as: it is a time consuming process, it is a technical process, it is an adversarial process, expensive provision of appeal and revisions and review, non-conducive environment, and this is also not friendly to a common people of this country. Reason for these shortcomings are: there are various less number of courts, our population is very high, non-conducive environment in the court, legal approach to adjudicate the dispute, complexity of the language issued in the litigation process, social and economical considerations are primarily at back and they are not taken into consideration while adjudicating the dispute in the court. There were various forms of dispute resolution mechanism in ancient India, and these forms were in Vedic period Puga, Sreni and Kula. These are the hierarchy of, in simple language we may say, courts to adjudicate the dispute. Puga means people of different sects and tribes but living in the same area. Sreni means comprised of trade and artisans groups. Kula means group of persons joined by the family. there were provision that a decision of Kula was assailed before Sreni and decision of Sreni was assailed before the Puga. Under Muslim law also, Qazi courts was there to adjudicate the dispute between the Muslims. Qazi court was guided by traditional Islamic laws. Panchayats were also existent at that point of time. Provisions of appeal was also existent at that point of time. And the variety of disputes were being adjudicated by these traditional mechanism, which includes matrimonial dispute, land dispute, financial dispute, criminal disputes, and these disputes were settled by these kind of mechanism. But there were no formal way to adjudicate the dispute, and there were scattered mechanism, and no uniformity of the law was existent at that point of time. With the intervention of Britishers in India, formal way of legislation started coming into the social life of Indians, and various legislations were passed by the Britishers and was enforced on Indians. In this paper, I will be taking you the present form of ADR and statute governing them after independence of India. These are arbitration, conciliation, mediation, judicial settlement, Lok Adalat, settlement with the intervention of family court, collective bargaining in the case of industrial dispute, and plea bargaining, a new concept introduced in the year 2003 in our criminal justice system. The arbitration and conciliation are presently governed by Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1996. Prior to this, we had Arbitration Act of 1940. There were various shortcomings in that act, and this new act passed in the year 1996, which is called Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1996, after liberalization of economy, seeks to achieve the shortcomings of 1940 Act, because in the 1940 Act there were provisions of appeal and there were various chances of intervention of the court. But in this act, the court interventions are kept at minimum level, so that the arbitrator appointed by the parties or in accordance with the act adjudicate the dispute as soon as possible, and there are various limited grounds available to the parties to challenge the award passed by the arbitrator. In the Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1996, there are provision of conciliation also. There are mechanism to appoint a conciliator, and the conciliator facilitate the dispute between the parties. Even otherwise, if the dispute is being adjudicated by the arbitrator appointed under Arbitration and Conciliation Act or with the agreement of the parties, is under duty to facilitate a conciliation between the parties. If that happens, then the arbitrator accordingly pass an award, or arbitrator may proceed on the merits of the case and following the procedure adopted by the party, or following the process as envisaged under Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1996, may finally pass an award. The award passed by the arbitrator are open to challenge before the court of competent jurisdiction, but only on various limited ground as provided under the act. Thus, this Arbitration and Conciliation Act firstly facilitate the adjudication of the dispute outside the court through arbitration or through conciliation, and the chance of court interventions are very minimum. Secondly, I will be talking about Section 89, Order 10, Rule 1A, 1B, 1C order 32A of the Code of Civil Procedure 1908. This is an innovative idea introduced in the year 2002, when the Code of Civil Procedure, which generally governs the civil dispute, and the civil law, which can be also called as the mother law of the civil dispute, was amended. Section 89 and Order 10, Rule A, 1, B and C was introduced in the year 2002. Section 89 mainly says that when the dispute is brought before the court, and if court see that there is any chance of settlement between the parties, then the court, after formulating a term of settlement, may give the settlement terms to the parties involved in the dispute for their observation, and after their observation, court may formulate a term and refer the party to any of the dispute resolution mechanism outside the court, which may include mediation, settlement with the intervention of Lok Adalat, conciliation, etc., meaning thereby that it is primarily a duty of the court under Section 89 and Order 10 and Order 32A of the Code of Civil Procedure to facilitate a dispute. Section 89 of the Code of Civil Procedure, which casts a duty upon the court to formulate a term of settlement and bring the party or refer the party to a mediation, arbitration, conciliation, is a prime objective to facilitate the party to come to a common ground and avoid adversarial order, which may be subject to appeal, revision, review, etc. Order 10, Rule 1A and 1B and also 1C of Code of Civil Procedure 1908 says that after admission denial of the document, admission denial of the document means party to a dispute files their respective document and either admit or deny the document filed by the other party, court may refer the party to resolve a dispute in any of the mechanism or through any mechanism as earlier discussed. Order 32, Rule A of Code of Civil Procedure 1908 says and mainly talk about family dispute. It says that when a family disputes are brought before the court and court thinks there is a chance of settlement, then court may formulate a term or court may refer the party to resort to any of the mechanism as discussed earlier. Family dispute includes matrimonial dispute, dispute about legitimacy, dispute pertaining to wills, property dispute, etc., meaning thereby Code of Civil Procedure cast a very heavy burden upon the court to facilitate the dispute adjudication or dispute settlement through arbitration, conciliation, mediation and Lok Adalat mechanism. Thirdly, there are three legislations which primarily govern the family relationship so far as Hindu laws are concerned. Family Court Act 1984, the Hindu Marriage Act 1955, the Special Marriage Act 1954. These act under various provisions provides that when a matrimonial dispute pertaining to divorce, maintenance, custody, etc. are brought before it, and if court is of the opinion that there may be a settlement between the parties, then court may refer those party to any of the alternate dispute resolution mechanism. In these provision, in nutshell, court may also ask the party to nominate a common person so that common person may adjudicate or decide the dispute or facilitate the parties to come to a common ground. Thirdly, Industrial Dispute Act 1947. As all of you are aware that industrial harmony is a must for the growth of any economy. Industrial dispute are defined under the Industrial Dispute Act 1947. For the growth of any economy, harmony in the industrial premises and employer and employee relationship is a must. To facilitate an industrial dispute adjudication, there are mechanisms under Industrial Dispute Act 1947, and Section 10A of the Act provides for an arbitration. If the arbitration is carried out for the adjudication of any industrial dispute as defined under Industrial Dispute Act 1947, then that award, if published, will be final and binding. No party to that award can challenge the award in any court of the law, meaning thereby there is also an element of alternative dispute resolution mechanism to adjudicate the industrial dispute. Third form of the alternate dispute resolution mechanism is plea bargaining, which is a new concept in India. In the year 2003, Code of Criminal Procedure was amended and concept of plea bargaining was introduced. Plea bargaining means accused accepts his guilt and expects that lesser sentence or fine will be imposed upon him. The benefit of plea bargaining is that it curtails the lengthy trial and the accused to avoid harsh sentence or fine may accept his guilt in return of lesser sentence and fine. This saves the time, energy of both criminal justice system and accused. This concept is at very beginning stage. However, this concept is gaining importance in these days. However, the limit of plea bargaining has been defined under Code of Criminal Procedure 1973, and only certain classes of offense comes under this plea bargaining concept. Benefits of ADR. As I earlier described, what are the mechanism to adjudicate the dispute? Now I will come, if the party to a litigation or party to a dispute resorts to any of the alternate dispute resolution mechanism as described earlier, then there are various benefits. First, this is speedy justice to the satisfaction of the parties at dispute, because the party themselves has chosen for the adjudication or settlement of dispute and the mechanism involved upon them. Procedure are flexible, because all the statute which I described earlier provide a flexible approach for the settlement of dispute, and the person facilitating the dispute are not bounded by the technical laws, as the technical laws are applicable in the court. Procedure at a time may be determined and controlled by the party to the dispute. Procedure of the adjudication or settlement through either arbitration or conciliation or mediation or with the intervention of Lok Adalat is determined by the parties to the dispute, and they are not subject to technical law as applicable in the court, so far as taking evidence, giving evidence, filing of the documents, cross examination, examination and chief are concerned. These processes are done away with when the disputes are settled through any of the mechanism as described earlier. It entails lower cost, it entails practical solutions, save energy, time, resources, afford confidentiality, preservation of relationship and preservation of reputation, etc. Confidentiality means if the party to a dispute resort to any of the mechanism as described earlier, and if they disclose any of the facts before mediator or conciliator or the arbitrator, while the disputes are being settled through any of the mechanism, then those facts cannot be taken into consideration if the disputes are brought back to the court. Now, I will be briefly talking about arbitration, duty of the arbitrator and approach of adjudication. Duty of the arbitrator is to act in accordance with the mandate of the act and the consensual approach or procedure and terms of the agreement between the parties to a dispute. Section 19 and 28 of the act provides that arbitrator is not bounded by Code of Civil Procedure 1908 or for that matter Indian Evidence Act 1872. Party may agree upon a procedure and procedure may be as per the agreement under the arbitration clause. Section 20 provides place of arbitration and party to a dispute can for mutual convenience choose a place where the arbitrator will sit and decide the dispute. Section 22 provides for the language of arbitration and this also gives freedom to the parties to choose a language. Section 26 provides expert appointment. Since arbitrator at some time may not be an expert to adjudicate the dispute, however, the arbitrator is at liberty to seek the help of an expert for adjudication of the dispute, especially those technical disputes. Section 27, court assistance in taking evidence. Sometime court may be asked by the arbitrator or for that matter may be requested by the arbitrator to take the evidence in the proceeding. Mediation and conciliation technique and approach. I have already described you the mediation and conciliation. Now, I will be telling you the technique and approach of mediation and conciliation. Difference between mediation and conciliation is blurred in India. There are various forms of mediation in India. Firstly, evaluative mediation. Secondly, facilitative mediation. Thirdly, therapeutic transformative mediation. And mediation needs to take account the cultural background, temperaments, economic position, mindset while attempting to negotiate the dispute between the party. Settlement are before the mediator, settlement are within the approach of the parties, and if the party come to a common ground, then the mediator may formulate a term and accordingly pass a settlement terms and refer the party to the court if the party has been referred before the mediator by the court, and court may record the dispute as settled. Now I will be describing the judicial settlement. Earlier discussed about the Code of Civil Procedure and the various provision of the Code of Civil Procedure. Section 89, Order 10 and Order 32A was discussed in detail. These process cast a duty upon the court to refer to any of the mechanism of alternate dispute resolution mechanism. If party to the disputes are referred by the court and if the arbitration takes place or a conciliation takes place, then the provision of Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1996 comes into picture. If the disputes are being settled by Lok Adalat, then the Legal Service Authority Act 1987 comes into picture. Similarly, if the disputes are being settled by plea bargaining, then the concept of plea bargaining as envisaged under Code of Criminal Procedure 1973 comes into picture. If the disputes are settled by Industrial Dispute Act, then the mechanism of alternate dispute resolution as described under Industrial Dispute Act comes into picture. Therefore, if the party to a dispute referred by the court and any of the alternate dispute resolution mechanism are resorted to, then the respective legislation governing those mechanisms come into picture. And if the party to a dispute settle the dispute before an independent mediator, conciliator or arbitrator, then it provides that the court fees paid by the parties in the court shall be returned as per section 16 of Court Fee Act, meaning thereby the party gets his money back from the court if they resolve the dispute through any of the alternate dispute resolution mechanism. Now, I will telling you about Lok Adalat. A statutory recognition of Lok Adalat was given by Legal Service Authorities Act 1987. Lok Adalat has power of civil court and is guided by the principle of justice, equity, fair play and other legal principles. Every award of Lok Adalat shall be deemed to be a degree of civil court. Case taken up by the Lok Adalat either with the consent of the party or is referred by the court. Lok Adalat endeavors to bring the parties to compromise or settlement between the parties and pass an award which is binding upon the parties and are not subject to any judicial intervention. Lok Adalat is currently organized from district level to national level, and at various level Lok Adalat takes up various number of cases ranging from electricity dispute, matrimonial dispute, accident dispute, etc. The class of disputes to be taken up by Lok Adalat is described under the Act. Once the disputes are referred before the Lok Adalat shall endeavor to settle the dispute between the parties, and if the party settle the dispute, then the award is accordingly passed, which is not subject to judicial intervention. The presiding officer of the Lok Adalat from state level to national levels mostly includes retired judicial official, advocate and the technical persons who are having experience to settle the dispute between the parties. Lok Adalat currently minimizing the burden of the court because the procedure before the Lok Adalat is very conducive to the party involved in the dispute. Matrimonial dispute and family court. Hindu Marriage Act 1995, section 34(3) of Special Marriage Act 1954, chapter 4 of Family Court Act 1984 are more or less on the same line and cast a duty upon the court before proceeding to grant any relief to endeavor to bring about a reconciliation between the parties, and for that purpose independent or common person may also be appointed. These acts in nutshell provides that court who is adjudicating a dispute of matrimonial nature firstly shall endeavor to reconcile or to bring party to the dispute to a common ground, so that the family disputes are settled with the intervention of common person agreed upon by the parties or suggested by the court, or common person appointed under various provision of the Act. Court in this process may also take the assistance of expert, which includes welfare expert, conciliator expert, etc. These provisions are mainly intended that the family relationships are preserved, and court shall not proceed unless until court makes an effort to settle the dispute. Now comes the industrial dispute. Section 10 of the Industrial Dispute Act 1947 provides for arbitration in the matter of industrial dispute. Industrial disputes are defined under Section 2 of the Industrial Dispute Act 1947. Section 18 of the Industrial Dispute Act states about person on whom the settlement and award are binding. Once the award is passed under the Industrial Dispute Act through arbitration, the award is binding, and if notified is not open to challenge before any court of the law. Thus, the Industrial Dispute Act also provide an alternate mechanism to settle the industrial dispute. The prime objective of the Industrial Dispute Act and the settlement mechanism envisaged under the Act is to bring a harmony so far as the relationship of employer and employees are concerned. Because for any economy to flourish, industrial harmony is a must, and without industrial harmony, industrial growth of the country cannot take place. Thus, for the growth of economy, it is necessary that the dispute arising during the course of industrial operations are settled within a time frame that to satisfaction to the parties, that is employer and employee. Thus, the Industrial Dispute Act also cast and in fact envisages a mechanism which comes under alternative dispute resolution mechanism. This plea bargaining concept was introduced in India in the year 2003 with the amendment of Code of Criminal Procedure 1973. This concept may be quite new to Indian criminal justice system, but it is well known abroad. However, this concept clearly defines the class of offenses which may be subject to plea bargaining. All offenses may not be subject to plea bargaining. Thus, the plea bargaining concepts save both time and energy of state accused as well as the criminal justice system, especially the court. Now, I will be telling you the constitutional goal of India so far as law and justice systems are concerned. Article 14 says the state shall not deny any person equality before the law or the equal protection of law within the territory of India. Article 39A reads as under: the state shall secure that the operation of legal system promotes justice on the basis of equal opportunity and shall in particular provide free legal aid by suitable legislation or scheme or in any other way to ensure that opportunities for securing justice are not denied to any citizen by reason of economic or other disabilities. These constitutional goals are achieved through alternative dispute resolution mechanism, and these alternative dispute resolution mechanism are one step to achieve the constitutional goal as envisaged under section 14 and 39A of the Act. The mechanism basically brings common people to the judicial system so that these people do not feel that the judicial system is not capable of responding to their demand of justice, that to speedy justice, that to economical justice, that to time framed bonded justice. Therefore, we summarize that in the present modern day society, alternate dispute resolution mechanism is a must so that our society flourish and make the growth. Thank you.